Hello everyone, welcome to educators.com. This is Surya Prakash, your Python trainer. This video is about control flow tools in Python. In this video, we will learn what is control flow tools and we'll discuss different types of control flow tools. Computer programs are divided basically in two types based on the flow of the program. The first one is the sequential flow. That is where your program is executed top to bottom. In the sequential flow, your code will be executed line by line, beginning from the line 1 to the end of the line. It will move in a incremental order and there won't be any repetition of the previous lines, or the script is not intelligent enough to take the decisions based on the conditions. It will just perform the actions given in the sequential order. So this is called as a sequential flow. So if you observe the first image on the screen, it is representing the sequential flow. So if you see that this is a part of my code, if you see this is a flow diagram of my program. So here I'm giving three actions. So let's say that the first box indicates the action 1 and the next box action 2 and the next third one indicates the action 3. So in sequential flow, whenever the action 1 is executed, the code will now move to the action 2, and then after successful execution of action 2, it will move on to the action 3. So it happens in a sequence of order. So this sequential flow happens with no control over the code. So coming to the control flow statements, where we use to make the program flow in a controlled manner, that is whenever you want to run a particular part of your code for multiple times, or whenever you want to take some decisions and execute a particular piece of code only in case of some true conditions. So at that time, control flow statements are very useful. So whenever you are looking to execute a particular piece of code based on the output of some particular condition, so at that time you can go for conditional statements, or this is mainly used whenever you want to take a decision based on some condition. So if we see a particular, this second image here, how a conditional statement looks like. So whenever your code flows in, so it will check for the condition. If it is true, then it will execute a particular piece of code shown in this image. So if it's false, then it will execute another piece of code. And based on the decision that's happening in this particular condition, your code will take the decision. So if it's true, it will act in some manner, and if it's false, it acts in another manner. So if you want to control your program in this manner, then we have if conditional statements, and whenever you want to loop or whenever you want to run a particular piece of code for multiple times, then you can use iterations or loops. So for some particular condition, if it is true, execute this particular piece of code for n number of times, then we can use this. So if you observe the third image in this box, white box, so it will give the brief introduction for a loop. So here if we can see that our code flow is input to this diamond box. So if it is true, it will execute the code which is available in the blue box, or we can say that in particular condition which you are provided in the loop. So it will execute and it will come out of the execution and it will again check for that particular condition. If it is true, it will execute the piece of code, or if it is false, then it will come out of the execution of that particular loop. So by using control flow statements, we can we can automate the programs and give intelligence to the program so that it will take decisions and it will execute the code based on some particular conditions, and it will loop the code for n number of times based on some particular conditions, and it helps us to automate the tasks easily and also to perform many complicated scenarios. If you see that these are the few commands or the statements those are available in Python in order to perform a conditional and loop operations. So if you say if you see that here if statements are available, if like any other language do the same conditional operations, so if, else if, and if else are available, and nested if statements are also available in Python. The syntax of the command and how to work with if statements can be in the next videos, stating working with if statements. And in similar, we can look for more information on for and break, continue and while in the next videos. So the for statement and the while statements are used for looping techniques, and break and continue are used in order to come out of the loops based on some particular conditions. Pass is a null statement that is available in Python. It has no particular meaning, and this pass statement is used whenever you want the code to be syntactically correct. So at that time we can use pass, and there is a separate video named working with pass in the next video. So please watch that video for more information on pass. So whenever your code doesn't require any particular command, or you don't want any logic to be executed in that particular piece of loop or in some particular function, so at that time you can use pass statement. The syntax for pass is just pass. By writing this, your command would be executed. So whenever you want to generate a particular sequence of numbers, so range function comes to your rescue. Python has an inbuilt function called range, which would generate a particular sequence of numbers based on the input for that particular function. So if you see that here, range of 10 would generate a list of values, that is 10 values. So here, whatever the number we provide, so that many number of elements would be written. So for range of 10, we'll get 0 to 9. So the end number, the end point, that will never be considered. For if we see, for example, in range of 1 to 10, it will start with 10, but the end of 10, it starts with 1, and the end number 10 will never be considered. So it will give 1, 2, 3 and till 9. So whenever you want to generate a few set of numbers, then at that time we can use range function. So the more information on range and how to define a different set of functions and how to work with functions, we can see in the next coming videos. And for more information on range function, please watch working with range function. Thank you for watching our video. Stay tuned for more information.